One of the most important dynamics that we're all talking about when it comes to the 2020 Democratic Party primary is this centrist versus progressive debate. I'm talking about, you know, the Bernie Sanders of the world versus the Joe Bidens and the Tim Ryans of the world. But what we often don't discuss is that in actuality, there's two types of centrists because, you know, not all centrists are made equal. In short, some of them are more loathsome than others. So what I mean is some centrists, they simply don't support progressive policy proposals. They don't support student loan debt cancellation. They don't support free college, and they don't support Medicare for all. I would put Amy Klobuchar in this camp. She simply will tell you that she doesn't support Medicare for all. She supports a more incremental approach to healthcare, and that's that. But then there's a different camp of centrists who don't just not support these policies, but they actually take their lack of support a step further and they proceed to lie about these policies. They're actually destructive. They spread misinformation and espouse right-wing talking points with regard to these policies. The biggest one is Medicare for All. You see John Delaney, Tim Ryan, and Joe Biden all tell you reasons why we shouldn't opt for Medicare for All, and these are talking points that come straight from the health insurance industry, because surprise, surprise, they take money from these industries. In fact, the health insurance industry is betting on Joe Biden's success in order to save their asses. So these people, they are destructive. There's a different kind of evil in that centrism. I mean, being simply apathetic and not caring enough to support something like Medicare for All, that's one thing. But when you go out of your way to be destructive and drive down support for policies by lying, that really is a special kind of evil. And Joe Biden has differentiated himself from all the other centrists by being the most destructive when it comes to Medicare for All. So as Sahil Kapoor of Bloomberg reports, a new poll by a firm linked to Joe Biden is testing messages designed to undercut support among Democrats for Medicare for All, one of the most contentious issues splitting the party's top presidential contenders. The survey commissioned by the centrist Democratic think tank Third Way found that primary voters start off favoring the government-run healthcare system by a margin of 70 to 21%, but can be persuaded to oppose it. The studies show that Democrats are most swayed by the arguments that the program would impose a heavy cost on taxpayers and threaten Medicare for senior citizens. The poll was conducted by Lisa Grove of Anzalone Litz Grove Research. Her partner, John Anzalone, is the chief pollster and an advisor to Biden who opposes Medicare for All and wants to make government-run insurance optional. So just pause for a moment and let's try to take all of this in. So the goal here is to try to figure out what talking points, what right-wing talking points specifically, will be the most effective in order to dissuade Democratic Party primary voters to turn against Medicare for All? That is disgusting. It's morally reprehensible because we all know what will happen if we keep the status quo. Now, think about this. Prior to the 2020 Democratic Party primary process, we were riding this really high wave of momentum for Medicare for All. Most polls showed that a majority of Americans support Medicare for All. In fact, some polls showed that 70 to 80% of Americans support Medicare for All. Some polls even started to show that a majority of Republicans support Medicare for All. But all of a sudden, the poll numbers start to dip a little bit once some Democrats jump into the race and start spreading lies. So that way, Democratic Party voters, after hearing all of these right-wing talking points from Fox News and Republicans and Donald Trump, well, now that they're hearing Democrats say it, well, what are Democrats doing? They're legitimizing these right-wing talking points that are fed to Republicans by the industry. And because these health insurance companies don't discriminate, they love Democrats and Republicans and pretty much anyone who's willing to do their bidding. Well, we're getting the same exact talking points, and now we're starting to see maybe that's starting to have an effect, and Joe Biden is now going out of his way to figure out which right-wing talking points he should use that will be the most effective. He's actively trying to drive down support for Medicare for All. I don't even know how to process this. It's so despicable, so destructive. This is worse than Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton just said, you know, Medicare for All single payer will never ever come to pass. There's a difference between just shitting on Medicare for All and actively trying to drive down support for Medicare for All. We're getting into the territory where you're starting to really show your true colors here. And Joe Biden, he showed his true colors long ago, but how low he's willing to go, I mean, we haven't seen what the bottom is yet. He literally used an ad where he invoked his son's death to argue against Medicare for All. And now he's going out of his way to destroy the public support for Medicare for All that grassroots activists and progressives have been trying to build over the course of the last 3 years. What a morally reprehensible goon this guy is. And why is he doing this? To protect the health insurance industry, because again, they're betting on him winning to save their asses, because a candidate like Bernie Sanders poses an existential threat to these health insurance companies. So of course, they are going all in to defeat Bernie Sanders and prop up his opponent, because they know if Bernie wins, it's game over for them. Now, speaking of Bernie Sanders, he responded to this, and here's what he said. Sanders took aim at the survey and some of the arguments it is designed to test. It is unfortunate but not surprising that Vice President Biden's polling firm is helping distort what Medicare for All is about, he said in a statement. Any tax increases would be used to eliminate costs for people seeking healthcare, Sanders said. Now, he also clarified what Medicare for All would entail. Let me be clear. Under my proposal, no one earning less than $29,000 will pay any new taxes, Sanders said. And for everybody else, except the very wealthy, what they will be paying in taxes will be far less than what they currently pay for premiums, copays, deductibles, prescription drugs, and other healthcare expenses. Financially, Medicare for All will be a great deal for the American people, added Sanders. And additionally, Bernie Sanders' senior advisor Warren Gunnels refuted one of the claims being made in a tweet, saying, "Disgusting. A poll firm linked to Biden is working overtime to mislead Americans about Medicare for All by echoing bogus GOP talking points. Fact, Medicare for All improves benefits for seniors by covering dental, vision, hearing, and home care." And that's exactly right. Every single person in this country will be better off under a Medicare for All system, with the exception of the executives in those healthcare companies. If you're a senior, you'll have expanded coverage. If you are a worker with private health insurance who pays your monthly premiums, not only will you no longer pay your monthly health insurance premium, but you will have better coverage than you have now, and you have peace of mind. If you have insurance, but you have an emergency and you go to a hospital that's out of your network, guess what? You're going to have to foot the bill because your insurance company isn't going to do that for you. So every single person in America will be better off, but because there is money that is at stake here, money that will be lost if Medicare for All comes to pass, Joe Biden is now scrambling to protect that industry. And he's doing it by lying to the Democratic Party base. This is absolutely morally reprehensible and despicable. And Joe Biden shouldn't just lose this primary. He should be shamed forever for what he's doing. Because to try to destroy public support for Medicare for All after some activists have spent years building up support for, and to use right-wing talking points that are lies, it's just morally reprehensible. Joe Biden is worse than Hillary Clinton. You can be a centrist and just not care about these policies. I would prefer that. But to try to destroy progressive momentum, that's a specific kind of evil that I do not respect and that I absolutely loathe. Shame on you, Joe Biden.